But Cheney and Rumsfeld changed it so it was planning to deal with any emergency, and they got an executive order passed under Reagan which redefined the purpose of COG was to deal with any emergency. And the amazing thing is these two people went on planning for, in effect, the suspension of the American Constitution, that's what it's been called, when neither of them were in the government.
But they were in the continuity of government, you know.
They were in this special thing that was set up under Reagan back in 1981 by a secret order. And there's a biography of Rumsfeld that suggests that Clinton didn't even know what was going on. And the people who were planning it, originally they were Democrats and Republicans, but in the 90s they were all Republicans.
Hold that thought. We're going to be back right after this. I do cover a lot of this in my film Fabled Enemies, the revamping of the continuity of government or shadow government program. Please check it out. It's the Alex Jones Show. I am Jason Berman sitting in. We'll be back with Cyrdale Scott after this. We are back. It's the Alex Jones Show. I am Jason Berman sitting in. Joining us in studio for PrisonPlanet.tv members is Peter Dale Scott. And we were just talking about this continuity of government program, which is the shadow government. Tell us how this integrates into the new Obama administration.
Continuity of government, COG, is a concept that every American should know about because it is a plan for, it's supposed to be, temporary suspension of the Constitution. And as I wrote in my book, The Road to 9/11, it was instituted for the first time on the morning, before 10 o'clock, on the morning of September the 11th, 2001, in response to these attacks. Now, that might have been an understandable response to an attack which they still didn't know the limits of, but that was codified into the declaration of a state of emergency on 3 days later, on September the 14th, and there is a law which says that these things have to be renewed. And so Bush renewed it as late as the fall of 2008. And then I and another, Dan Hamburg, a former congressman, we started a campaign that Obama should end this once and for all. And he had let us down. He renewed it just this last month. He's renewed it again. And this is a plan, we don't even know what it means. Congressman DeFazio back in 2007, when he saw that Bush had, again, his thing, he was on the Homeland Security Committee, so he saw that there were certain secret orders, and he was on the oversight subcommittee that should have seen those orders, so he asked to see them. He was told that he didn't have the clearance to see them, because COG has its own clearances. This is why I think the report, there's certain things, the 9/11 report, certain things it just can't talk about. They can't find the certain orders because they were done at a higher level of clearance than they had to in order to write the report. Well, his whole committee wasn't able to see them. But there's another part of the law, and I feel like a voice in the wilderness here because nobody's picked up on this, but it's right there in the law that if a state of emergency is declared, Congress must review it within 6 months and either ratify the state of emergency or close it down. So, as I say, this ex-Congressman Dan Hamburg and I said, well, Congress, you've had 8 years now, and you're supposed to do it in 6 months. So, for heaven's sakes, do it. And we tried to mobilize a campaign to get everyone to write to their congressman. And one congressman wrote back and said, well, that provision of the law is no longer operative because it has been overridden by, guess what, continuity of government. Well, this is the whole issue of, as you said, three branches of government and checks and balances. If a small group of people, two of whom are not even in the government, can set up a new set of rules which are brought in under the shadow of this attack on September the 11th, and Congress is told that they can't review it when the law says that they must review it, we have a disturbing situation. And when nobody in the media I say there's the mainstream media, now we have the mainstream internet too, and then we have people like you and me. The mainstream internet has not picked up on this, but this whole thing should be looked at, and Congress should, first of all, should find out what secret rules are being put in. I mean, somebody in Congress should have the right to do that. We have an intelligence committee that can look at what the CIA is doing. I would have thought that Homeland Security would be the people who could see what are the secret rules to deal with Homeland Security. This is, I think, a kind of line in the sand whether we're going to go on having a tripartite constitutional frame of government or not.
Well, unfortunately, the dumbed-down public thinks that the shadow government is nothing more than something you would see in a James Bond movie. They don't even know that it exists, Mr. Scott. And I mean, that's just the reality.
Well, I think they see more and more they did. What happened in Pittsburgh, for example, that's not the American way of doing things. You know, you have a small group of peaceful protesters, and these companies have these brand-new weapons they want to try out, and you know, members of the press getting arrested. No, I can't say arrested, detained. He was not booked, right?
Yeah, no, not booked at all.
Just detained so that they can see that things are changing.
Absolutely. All right, final segment coming up with Peter Dale Scott, one of the great minds of our time, folks. I can guarantee that his work will go down in history, author of The War Conspiracy and much more. It's the Alex Jones Show. I am Jason Burma sitting in. We'll be back after this. Infowars.com, PrisonPlanet.tv.